Let's do a bunch more of these addition problems. So let's say I have 9,367 plus 2,459. So we can do this the exact same way we've done in the last few videos. We start in the ones place, or you can even think of it as the ones column. So you're going to add the 7 ones plus the 9 ones. So you're going to have 7 plus 9, which we hopefully know by now, is 16. So what we do is we write the 6 in the ones place, and we carry the 1. So if this 1, let me switch, if this 1 is going to be the same thing as that 1, right there. And this might look like a little bit of a mystery or magic. And the whole reason we did that is that this is the tens place. And when you write 16, you have 6 ones and 1 10. If you view this as money, what's the best way to get $16 in a world where there weren't $5 bills, where you only had $1 bills, $10 bills, $100 bills, and so on? Only multiples of 10. And we don't have any $5 bills. In that world, you would represent 16 as one $10 bill. One $10 bill, just like that. And then 6 $1 bills. So that's 2 $1 bills. That's 2 more $1 bills. And then that's 2 more $1 bills. And so 16 is, so the whole reason why I'm drawing it this way, why I'm even using this analogy or drawing the dollar bills, is to show you what these places mean. When I say that this right here is the tens place, I'm essentially telling you how many $10 bills do I have if I have $16 and I'm doing it as efficiently as I can in a world without $5 bills. I only have ones, tens, and hundreds, and $1,000 bills, and so forth. And this is the ones. So when I write it this way, I'm literally telling you I have one $10 bill, and I have 6 $1 bills. That's what $16 is. And so when I have 7 plus 9 is equal to 16, I say that I have 6 $1 bills, and I have one $10 bill. And I add that one $10 bill to everything else in the tens place. And the tens place is essentially telling you how many. That's the tens. I could write it like that, or I could write the tens place. That when I have 67, 67 means I have 6 $10 bills plus another 7 ones. So that's 6 tens, 5 tens. So I add up everything in the tens place. So 1 plus 6 plus 5, let me do that in a new color. 1 plus 6 plus 5 is equal to 1 plus 6 is 7. 7 plus 5 is 12. So I write the 2 in the tens place, because remember, this is 12 $10 bills, right? Because we're in the tens place. So I have 2 in the tens place, and then I put the 1, I carry this one right here, into the hundreds place. Because if I have 12 $10 bills, I have $120. I have one $100 bill, and I have two $10 bills. And I'll stop going into the dollar bill analogy just so we can make sure we understand the process. But I think you see how it works. You start at the right, you add the two numbers up. If it's a two-digit answer, you carry the leftmost digit up to the next column, and you just keep doing that. So let's do this one right here. 1 plus 3 is 4. Let me write this down in another color. 1 plus 3 plus 4. 1 plus 3 plus 4. 1 plus 3 is 4, plus 4 is 8. So 1 plus 3 plus 4 is 8. Nothing to carry. It was a one-digit number. And then finally, I have 9 plus 2. 9 plus 2. That's equal to 11. So I write the 1 down there. I write this 1. And then if there was anything left here, I would carry the tens or the other 1, the 1 in the tens place in 11. I would carry it. But there's nowhere to carry it to. So I write it down just like that. So 9,367 plus 2,459 is 11,826. And I just put that comma there because it's easier for me to read. Let me do a bunch more of these. Let's do a really, really daunting problem. Let's do something in the millions. Just to show you that you can do any problem. So let's say we have 2,349,015. Let's throw a 0 in there, right? We have nothing in the hundreds place there. And I want to add that to, I'll switch colors just for fun. I want to add that to 7 million, let's put a 0 there, 15,999. Let's add these two numbers. It seems like a hard problem, but if we just focus on each of the places, I think you'll find that it's not too bad. So we start off with 5 plus 9. 5 plus 9, that's equal to 14. Write the 4 down here, carry the 1. Then you go into the tens place. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 plus 9, let me switch colors. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 plus 9 is 11. Carry the 1. Now we're in the hundreds place. 1 plus 0 is 1, plus 9 is 10. So we write the 0 from the 10, carry the 1. Let me switch colors again. 1 plus 9 is 10. 10 plus 5 is 15. 15. Now we're in the 10,000s place. 1 plus 4 is 5. And 5 plus 1 is 6. And there's nothing to carry. Now we're in the 100,000s place. 3, we have nothing to carry, so we just have the 300,000 plus 0 hundred-thousands. Well, that's just 300,000. And then finally, we're in the millions place. 2 million plus 7 million is 9 million. Just like that. So this is a super crazy number. 2,349,015 plus 7,015,999. Just by keeping track of our places and carrying the two-digit numbers, or the second digit in the two-digit numbers as necessary, we're able to figure out that the answer is 9,365,014. So hopefully this gives you a pretty good sense. So let me just do one more, just to really make sure that we really understand how all of this carrying business works. So let's do 15,999,001 plus 6,888,999. Let's just see how this one's going to turn out. This seems like a difficult problem, but once again, if we just focus and don't get lost, we're going to get the right answer, hopefully. So 1 plus 9 is 10. Write the 0, carry the 1. 1 plus 0 plus 9 is 10. Write the 0, carry the 1. 1 plus 0 plus 9, that's 10 again. Write the 0, carry the 1. Now 1 plus 9 is 10, plus 8. 10 plus 8 is 18. Write the 8, carry the 1. 1 plus 9 is 10, plus 8. Is 18. Write the 8, carry the 1. 1 plus 9 is 10. Plus 8 is 18. Write the 8, carry the 1. Now we're in the millions place. 1 million plus 5 million is 6 million. Plus 6 million is 12 million. Write the 2 million and then carry the 1. Because 12 million is 2 million plus 10 million. 10 million plus 10 million, right? This is 1 10 million plus another 1 10 million, right? That's 1 plus 1 is 2. And then we are done. 15,999,001 plus 6,888,999 is 22,888,000. So, you know, you just saw, we're doing 7 and 8 digit number additions. But you could apply this, if I had a number with 100 digits in it, you could do the exact same thing. You just have to go start at the right, go each column by each column, and then if you end up with a two-digit answer, when you add the two one-digit numbers, you just carry the tens place. You just keep doing that and work your way left, and if you make no errors, you'll get the right answer.